having that many in fines that's not getting paid, and wasn't punishing. If you're going to violate the law and you're not ordered to pay your fines, what is your punishment? So we're going to go back and we're going to get those fines collected, because that's $3 million that would assist the budget that's around here. There is a program in the state of Illinois now that those can be turned over to collection agency. It's not the county that has to pay the collection fee, it's the offender. They can collect up to 30% of what the total fine is from the offender. So if you have a $100 fine you didn't pay, you're now paying $130. And collection agencies, they get paid by collecting from the people. I know that Rock Island has been turning theirs over. They've actually collected, I think I heard here, $1 million just by turning it over. Since you have budget problems here, wouldn't it be nice to have part of it paid by the people that are violating the laws of the state in this county? I'm always available to be talked to. I've been out quite a bit. As I said, I've got another event kind of two purposes. I enjoy getting out to antique crackers and stuff like that. I also like meeting people. A little bit about me is my grandfather ran a grain elevator for years when I was a kid. I was never a farmer, but I grew up around them, and I think any kid that's grown up around them at some point has a scarf from barbed wire. Mine's kind of faded over the years, and it used to be in the palm of my hand. Now it looks like one of those worry lines or whatever. I have enjoyed being out here, I've enjoyed meeting the people. I'm always open to listen to what you have to say. And if you want to tell me, that needs to be done at the prosecutor's office, please feel free to tell me. I will be available. Jason was going to get a hold of me. My phone's always available. Feel free to call me. I won't be like the current prosecutor who I talked to, or have to talk to him, but one of his constituents had to tell me that he came into his establishment. One of the voters in Mercer County came up to want to talk to him, and he got up and left. I don't intend to do that. I intend to be open. I intend to talk to whoever wants to talk to him. You can talk to the people that you're talking to, but they know I'm open. I haven't just walked away from the spot. I'm also going to have a front page of prosecutor. I have experience. I know that there's right now a murder case is here. I know from talking to people, it's kind of languishing. I also know that the prosecutor is not allowed to prosecute because he's afraid of what people might think he loses. That's not the way to do it. You grab the bull by the horns and you take over. I've done 6 murder trials. I'm familiar with them. I know what goes on. I've had a murder case that involved a nationally renowned forensic anthropologist. I don't know if I watch his bones, but this guy is the bones of the real world. It's things you have to learn. It's more being a prosecutor. At one point, I could probably tell Brian his job because I have to learn different things. But I forgot them a lot, because once the trial's over, you don't need to know that anymore. Studied DNA, to be a DNA expert at one point. Gone through forensic anthropology. Do I remember all that? No. But I have the ability to learn when it comes time to trial. And I won't be around for any questions. And I'll turn this over.
Wow. Brian's saying, get lost.
Thank you.